As you all aware, like the current training is this is a overview session which I'm giving today. So when I say overview, it is like so what is this particular what are all I'm going to cover in this training, and what is the use of this training in the current market. So all those things we will discuss. As I said, like we will be just I will go through this session. And if any open questions are there, we will discuss in at the end all those open questions, everything. And so the training, the main skill of this training is Power BI. Okay, so Power BI is a business intelligence tool where so we can create reports connecting with various data sources. With a lot of visualizations available, like bar charts, pie charts, donut chart, or like hundreds of visuals are there, custom visuals and default visuals. Using them, we can create the reports. Using this particular, reports, so people can analyze their business and they can understand about their business. So which will help them, to take actions about their business. That is the main thing is business intelligence. Analyst tool, this Power BI, it is basically it helps to analyze their business. That is the main motto of this particular in this particular Power BI which people use for. And the next one is like, if you could see, I'm also covering of data warehousing and SQL Server and the MSPI SSAS Tabler. It is a data modeling tool. Okay, so SQL Server is the one like where sometimes, right, whatever the reports we generate or develop it, in order to, perform the testing also, I want to validate that initially when I develop the report, whether the numbers are correct or wrong. To verify that, so we use the SQL Server, where basically we will be, writing SQL query to, test that particular one, right? So that is the reason we will be using SQL Server here. In this particular training, I will be covering that SQL Server also. Basics and advanced SQL concepts I'll be covering with on SQL Server side. And also data warehousing side. So data warehousing is something where in interviews, right, it will be like they will be checking, what are the data models are there. It is like all about to learn about data. What is data? What kind of models are there? So those kind of things we will be, learning in the data warehousing side. So where we get some of the questions on interview side, so which we will be, covering by me. Okay. And data modeling tool. So why is this data modeling tool is required? MSPI SSAS Tabler, right? So Power BI has certain limitations when we are working with huge data. If you want to make a report with very, very huge data, right? So there are certain limitations with Power BI tool, right? So some organizations or some projects, right, they will be using SSAS Tabler model tool. It is a data modeling tool. So where we can create a data model using SSAS Tabler model. So with a huge data and deploy that model, and we can connect with Power BI using that model and create the reports. So end of the day, again, we use Power BI for, data analysis purpose, creating the visuals and all. Right, but when it comes to huge data, some projects uses separate data modeling tool, which is SSAS Tabler. So that is also there. So basically, in my training, I'm going to cover with. Initially, I'll start with the data warehousing concepts. This is to know about basics of data theoretically, like what are the data models are there in data engineering side. So which model is efficient? So where exactly we get the data, what kind of data it is, and where we store it practically. So where we can store the data, how we can create a data modeling there, right? And then we will talk about like Power BI, like connecting with the data. So we will cover end to end in Power BI also, like each and every options. Then we will start with the data modeling tool. And so this is how the training will be, covered. So basically, even though the primary skill is Power BI, I'll be covering all other these modules also, SQL Server and data warehousing and this one. So which will help you to learn these relevant skills. And when it comes to applying the jobs also, it will be good for you. Okay. I will also refer like, you know, my Tableau videos. Tableau is also one of the business intelligence tools similar to Power BI. So those also videos which is available. You can subscribe to this channel and go through this playlist to learn about these other area also, basically ETL tool and cloud and Tableau. So if you want to go through that, you can go through that subscribing this to channel. Okay. So this is the on what I'm going to cover in this particular training. Okay. So when it comes to just to understand about what is this particular business intelligence, like Power BI we're learning, right? It is a business intelligence tool. So why companies are, you know, investing in business intelligence tool? As I already told, right? So business intelligence tool, right? So business intelligence means here knowledge actually, right? So business knowledge it will give, which one? This Power BI tool. Business knowledge, how it is giving. So whatever the data we have it, right? So we are connecting with the data and we are representing in visuals like bar chart, pie chart, right? Line chart. So like all these visuals, users can easily understand their data. Okay. If you look at here, so business intelligence is a process that helps us to change data into information. Whatever the data we have it in our business, so that it is going to be changed into information. That information into knowledge we get it, right? So we are seeing this information with that, how what is happening. So we are able to analyze the data about our business, right? The same knowledge. So whatever the knowledge we have it, using that particular knowledge, so we can, you know, it will help us to guide how we want to proceed, right? So that is, it is also going to be doing with this particular business intelligence tool. Okay, so one second. Yeah, so this is the mainly to talk about. It is a simple thing that we have the data and we connect with the data and we create a reports. That reports will help us to quickly, you know, analyze our business, what is happening on daily basis. Okay, if you take any business or any company which is having, right, operations, they will be having the data, right? It could be small scale company or, you know, medium or high scale company, like big scale companies also. It could be any company. So we will have data in that. If they want to understand their data, this kind of business intelligence tools generating insights, right, through visualizations, so which will help for data analysis purpose. So that is the reason companies will be choosing, you know, this particular business intelligence tools. So let's say if you take any company, like for example, if you take any retail ones also, like Swiggy or Zomato, or even Amazon.com, or even any of the online cloth like Myntra, or any retail or manufacturing units, like, you know, any companies which Intel, which will be generating the chips and all, it will be there, right? Intel processors or Lenovo. So kind of any company, it is like some example I'm giving, they get the data. For example, if I want to Zomato, right, which usually delivers the food and all, or Uber is a cabs, right? We all know. So, right? So Uber will have the data. If they wanted to know in this particular region, let's say in Karnataka or in Telangana or in Tamil Nadu. So what is the business happened today? How many rides happened? So what is the business happened today? If they want to get complete overall information, all the data will be stored in the, you know, their database. In one of the database, it will get stored. And if they want to understand their data, that particular data through Excel or in the database, it will be quite difficult process, right? So what is that they can do is they can connect with their data into this particular, BI tools, and they can, we can like create visualizations and so that, you know, it will be helpful, useful, and quickly they can understand. So what has happened, right? So hourly, how much revenue it is generated. So what is the business, high business hours they get it, like on which hour we get regularly more business, right? So on which hour people book and some of the cabs are not available. For example, I'm talking about Uber cabs, right? So if they provide more things that time, they can even generate more business also. Otherwise, if it is not available, they will go with another provider, right? So Ola cabs or something they will go with. So in order to understand their business or in order to improvise their business, right? So this kind of data analysis helps a lot to improve their business. I'm telling about small thing, which is cabs, right? So for example, if you take any of the milk company, right? So milk company, they will have a lot of, stores or distributors. They will be looking for, daily basis to get the milk, how much milk they wanted, right? So they will be, keeping their order in somewhere in the portal so that, they can, that data will be, given to the, operations team, and that operations team can, work on that to, to transport that particular one to particular, place, right? So in which, so who is transportation is happening? How is the operations is happening? Everything will be tracked in terms of, data, right? How many packets it has been sold. So kind of thing, any company, if it is a small scale company or any company, let's say if Amazon.com, right? If they want to know how much how many people are ordered, and for them, they want to deliver within the committed date. So who is taking responsibility, right? So when they order something, it go and feed into some of the database system, right? So it is like that, like the data gets feeded there, and we want to understand to run the business also. Or even banking system, if you take any of the banks, State Bank or HDFC or ICICI Bank, any banks, if you take it, right? So we will have the data again there also, right? So if you go to ATM, so the transaction will be started and the data has to be kept there, right? If they want to understand, so what is the, peak transactions is happening, which hour so many transactions happening, right? So because of too many transactions, their system should not be very slow, right? It should work very faster. So kind of thing, any company, if you take it, if they want to understand how many disputes are there, in dispute transactions are there, or everything, right, to manage the data, everything, it's all about, like, working on the data and analyzing the data, right? So business intelligence tools helps them, with the help of this visualizations, it will help them to, create the reports, and which will easily, within less time, they can understand their business and take actions further on it, right? Some places it will help us to analyze their business. Some places, in order to run the business only, we want this kind of, tools where how much is happening, where it is happening, right? To do that. So everything nowadays, it is like in the digital world, right? So we are all working with the data only. Yeah. So that is the reason, like, there is a lot of scope for business intelligence in the market always. Okay. So yeah. So I want to take you through further here. So if you look at how this entire process will go, the business intelligence process, right? So we get the raw data. Raw data means the source data. For example, if you take Amazon.com, if I order something just now, right? So that is nothing but So that raw data is getting into feed into one system, right? So it will be like here only it is the raw data. Whatever I place it, it will be there in one of the database. Usually we call technically OLTP database. Source system, I can say source database. Okay, so we'll talk about that in further classes very clearly. So what is that OLTP, all these things, okay? So OLTP system, it will be storing with that data. So we store it in a proper manner because, so whatever the data we get it, everything we may not require also, or we may require, but it is not, we are storing not as per the proper structure, right? So what we do is, we'll store in a proper warehouse. For example, if I have to tell you a simple example, so we have a medical shop is there, medical shop, Apollo medical shop or any medical shop, right? If you go to medical shop, right, I want some medicines, right? So they will quickly get that medicine within, minutes of time, within a minute, because they have organized that particular medicines in proper shelves and all, right? So they have kept proper shelves and they're, kept that particular medicines in proper shelves so that they are already aware that quickly they can go and pick that medicines and they can give it to us. But if same thing in the same medical shop, if they throw randomly all the medicines in that particular room, right, that shop, right? If they throw everything randomly, in order to get it, will take longer time. Same fashion in data warehousing also we have it. Data warehousing means a place where we store all the business data, right? Whatever the business is happening, we want to store that data in effectively. So we will learn about this data warehousing in upcoming lessons clearly. So with the help of ETL tool, we load the data, extract, transform, unloading. So we'll be doing it and we're loading it into proper place. Okay. From that, we will be taking the useful information. For example, I'm looking about, what is the volume is there? How much products are there in our all the stores or in the data warehouse, right? Like, I would like to know then, so I can take that information only, I can create the visualizations. So visualizations means using Power BI, right? So we connect with the data and we create the visuals like bar chart, line chart, or pie chart. This kind of visuals only, we have hundreds of visuals where we will get to know when to use which visuals, everything and all in the training, right? So that we create the reports, right? Using this report, it will be easy for the, their particular business management or higher level management to take the decisions actually, right? So we can make this way or that way, they will discuss it after discussing. Right. So whatever the best way is there, they can think of it and they can go ahead with that strategy to improve their business. Right. Simply if they don't do, if they take the decisions blindly without analyzing what is happening in their business with the help of actual numbers, right, it will be difficult to get in success in their business. Right. It's all about, we want to talk about actual numbers, what is happening. They want to take the decisions. So that is the reason, like it's always, helpful. Sometimes, right, even the using the existing data, using, some of the machine learning, Python or this kind of tools, right, like scripting language. So we can generate the future data also, so that we can, do forecasting and predicting the future customer behavior and requirements. Based on that also, we can plan for the future and we can run the business. So this is all end of the day, we will be doing it in the business intelligence. So this data, again, we generate it and we load it. Again, we showcase that in terms of the visualizations. So this is how the whole cycle it goes in business intelligence, any of the projects. So if you're working on, so we get the data and we, understand the data of the required required one, and we create a proper structure and load it. And we create the insights with the help of, this charts, which is available like bar charts, pie charts. and then we will be publishing the reports and giving the access to the people so that you know they can take the decisions. Okay, so that is how the whole cycle will be working. So if you look at, this is a standard project architecture. If you look at, so we will be having different sources. If it is like, you know, it company to company, number of sources and where and all that I get the data, right? So that will be depends actually. So we have different sources. So with the help of ETL tool, so we load the data into one place, and from there, what data is required, we will be storing in a proper warehouse system. So all these things we will learn about in upcoming lessons in very detail. And then we connect with the BI analytics, BI tools like Power BI or Tableau or any of the tool. So where we create the reports and dashboards, and then we will be giving the access to the users. This is how the standard architecture of a project looks like. Okay, so same thing. So we implement like this. Okay, so this is like for your idea and information, how it is looking like. So, and if you look at here, there are different domains we will be working with the data, right? So let's say if I currently I'm working on one of the project, it could be any of this particular domain only or industry only, right? So if you get a job, right, it is a financial one, financial project, correct? So financial means it could be, let's say, HDFC Bank or SBI. So kind of banks data. It is not only this, I'm giving an example, right? So we have, you know, some thousands of banks are there, entire the globe, right? So we will be dealing with financial data. So in that data, we will be creating the reports on that. So we'll have manufacturing clients are there, healthcare clients are there, e-commerce, energy, electrical, food and beverages, aerospace and telecom. So any of the projects, mostly in Indian side, right? Like Indian market. So we'll have the projects, most of the projects coming from financial, manufacturing, e-commerce, food and beverages, and very less on this area, like electrical and electronics. And healthcare also we get the project mostly. So aerospace and telecommunication, these are like bit less project, but mostly on these projects we get it, right? It could be any project or any industry, doesn't matter. End of the day, we want to work with their data. So for that, we want to understand their requirement, business requirement, and create the reports using this kind of tools. Okay, so where in your resume also, right, you'll be keeping any client, right? You have to work for a client only, right? So that particular one, we will be keeping it. What domain it is, client. What domain means it is a financial, retail domain. I mean, product based, like manufacturing, healthcare. So this is also retail, right? So food and beverages. So like that domain will be there, and that domain will be working with. It could be any domain, it doesn't matter. End of the day, we will be working on, you know, report developments. Yeah. So as I told, like, this is like, again, when it comes to implementation, actually, if you look at end-to-end business intelligence project tool. So here, what is a business intelligence tool? It has been used at the end, right? Always, right? So when you are working on Power BI or Tableau or any of the business intelligence tool, so we'll be at the end. When I say at the end, so we are the one, so we will be, you know, giving insights to the, you know, higher management or the people, so who can, you know, analyze their, you know, business, right? So whoever is working, like this is the end-to-end project flow. So whatever the data we get it from wherever the source is, so with the help of ETL team, there will be ETL team or database team, we call it with. So what they do is they create a, you know, jobs actually, right? And they will schedule the jobs on daily basis to pick the data from different sources and load into the database. Okay. From database, we'll be connecting with BI tool to create the reports, right? So that, you know, so whatever the latest information is there, so we'll schedule them in BI side also, so that always this reports will show whatever the reports we develop, those reports will show us latest information. Okay, so that is what this BI tool will be doing with. Okay, so we Power BI is also one of the easiest tool, but when you compare with Tableau and Power BI, right? So Tableau is one of the easiest tool, I could say that. Sorry, Power BI is one of the easiest tool where, you know, for developers, there are a lot of DAX functions are there, straightforward DAX functions. If you learn that DAX functions, right? So it's easy that we can easily work on it. So main, thing in both the tools is like the functions only, right? So there are like in Tableau, a lot of custom functions we need to use it for some of the requirements as per the, you know, business requirements. But when it comes to Power BI, so there are like, lot of straightforward functions are there, so which will help, you know, us like to create the measures quickly as per the requirements and create the reports. If you look at, you know, the here, project to project, the ETL tool and storage will be changing and BI also. But if you're working for a Power BI project, the Power BI will be constant. At the end, the Power BI will be visualizations tool will be Power BI only. It could be anything. It doesn't matter for us. It could be Informatica or anything, right? If I have to tell you, in market, we don't have one brand of phones, right? Mobile phones, same fashion. So we have N number of BI tools are there in the across the globe, actually, right? N number of storage databases are there, N number of ETL tools are there, right? So out of which, if you wanted to understand about where is that Power BI standing, right? So where is the Power BI and Tableau? If you could see, Tableau is also one of the tool, right? So if you look at here, when you compare with topmost BI tools, topmost BI tool means Power BI and Tableau. If you compare with, you could see 2015, according to Gartner analysis, right? So Tableau was there number one previously, and Microsoft Power BI was there third position on 2015. But as on now, when I say as on now, 2021, in this particular year, right? So Microsoft Power BI stays at number one position in the market. Right, you could see Microsoft becomes number one, second place becomes, you know, Tableau. Right, so there are like other tools also there. Out of all the mobiles, so which mobile is good? Maybe like we cannot say that, like, but here, so most using tools for, you know, to create the reports on this one, right? So first one is Power BI, second one is Tableau. But Tableau is there since 2012 onwards, almost 9+ years are there. But we have Power BI, people started using mostly, right? So from, 2016 onwards, 2016 and 2017, from that time onwards, people started using 2017 mostly, right? Which means Power BI is a new tool in the market. Still, it has been like 3+ years, but still people are adopting slowly, like now only like, to use Power BI as a business intelligence tools for the, you know, projects to analyze the data. So that is the reason, and it is an easy tool, and license wise, it is very, very less. So Tableau was like, you know, somewhere around $100 previously per user, but it is $10, 10 times less than the price also. So, and also it is like, it is having a lot of factors. If which factors it is number one, right? If you look at ability to execute and completeness of vision in these two areas. So Power BI is so good. That is the reason it is staying in number one position. And also cost wise, it is also good. So after Power BI has come, Tableau also reduced, but still it sits at number one position in terms of, you know, capabilities which the tool has. Okay, so that is the reason, like, as it is a new tool in the market, there are a lot of opportunities are there, and it is easy to learn also. So we have to learn that particular small tool, how to use that tool, each and every option. So we should be knowing, then we will be able to work on it. Okay, so I'm going to take you through about this particular tool right now, and so that you know, so we can understand how this tool it is going to be looking like. Okay, let me open this Power BI tool to talk about interface and how it is looks like. Okay, so we can easily install this small Power BI tool in our laptop, and so we can work on it. It is a for learning also, there is no license tool only, so which is available, and so we can use it for learning purpose as well. Okay, so yeah, so let me open this tool. Like I'm just opening this so that I will take you through what is this tool, so how simple it is, so that you get more idea about this tool. Okay, yeah, it is opening, so let's wait for a few seconds. So this is the interface of the Power BI tool. Okay, so we'll talk about one by one. What is that options are there? What it is there here? We will talk about that. Yeah. So this is the tool, right? Like this is a small tool, I could say. Right, in this, but this is a Power BI tool, interface of Power BI tool. So where in upcoming classes, right, so we will be going to learn about this particular tool, each and every option, right? It's a business intelligence tool, and it is a very easy to learn also. Like for example, you could say it is a number one tool in the market, so where we can create the reports, right? So I want to just tell you like one difference. If I'm creating a report, one report, same report I'm developing in Tableau, it is taking 1 week time. I can complete that report in 2 days time in Power BI. So that much simple, the time taking also when you, if you want to create the report in Power BI. Okay. So how quickly we can do it is something. It is based on how much knowledge and how to use that tool we should be knowing. For example, if you take a mobile, right, so that mobile, if you want to explore what and all options are there, right, so the mobile is also one of the tool. Consider that if you want to know, if you want to use it like that mobile, all the options, right, so we should know each and every option, right, then we can able to utilize that features of that particular mobile. Similarly, so this is a business intelligence tools, right? So where we can create the report here. It is very simple. Let me just save this particular one also. Let's say I will just save as, demo file. Okay. So for this particular one, so we want to connect with the data. So in order to connect with the data, so let me just connect with, any of the database. So which we will connect it quickly so that I will show you how simple it is, this tool, how to use it, or we can have some understanding there. So I will just go with SQL server. I mean like server, in the server we have a database data, right? So I'm just connecting with the data and importing the data. Okay, so if you give the server credentials, right, it will take us to inside, so where we can choose in tables, required tables to load, and we can use it for report development. If you could see, I just take one of the tables, one or two tables, I will just take it. So I have selected a few tables and load them. Okay, so if you look at, so I just taken few tables and I'm just loading it, right? So in order to tell you, like once we load the data, we can see that data at the end, right? So once we load the data, so we can see this complete tables, whatever we loaded, at the end. Okay, so and using that particular data, using these visualizations, right? So we create a report. Report means like we can create a report using the visualization. For example, a bar chart I have taken, and if you search with some of the fields here, I would like to see the data region-wise, how much sales happened. For example, I would like to see region-wise how much sales happened. So I will be able to do it, right? So otherwise, like same thing. So region wise, it is we are showing in the bar chart. Similarly, so I would like to see the data like category wise, how much sales happened, right? So we can also take another chart where we can choose another field name, right? And we can take that sales also, and we will be able to show the data, right? So like that, if you want to show the data like same fashion, like month wise how much sales is happening, right? So month wise how much sales is happening, I would like to know that. So then I will be able to show that data in the help of so this line chart also, right? So I will take this particular one and take the sales measure. And if I would like to know the same sales on different regions, how it is happening, then we can also drag and drop, right? So like that, we can do it. See, right now I just dragged and dropped, right? It is a drag and drop only. We don't have to work too much actually here. Where we get the work is, it is not like everything we can drag and drop simply, right? So we want to learn the DAX functions. That is the backbone of Power BI tool. Right. So here it is sales I am tracking. I may look for current year sales or some of the other logic we want to build it. So all those things we can do it with the DAX functions. Okay. And also we should not blindly use all these visuals. We should know when to use which visual. Right. And sometimes so there will be some structure of the data. You could see this is the report tab where we can create the report. Here this is the one where we can see the data. How is the data looks like? We can click on each of the table and we can see the data here, right? Sometimes this current structure of the data, whatever we have it from the source, right? So which will not be helpful to create a report. To create this report, the structure also we should know. So those kind of structure, what is the format we need the data structure? If proper format is not there, how we want to transform the data using this transform options, we can go inside. So we can work on to structure the data. All the transformations we can learn about here in this tool, right? How to get the data structure in proper manner, the transformations we can work on it, and data modeling, right? If we are creating a report with multiple tables, right? So where we will be making the join using the common field. So how the data modeling can be done. So we'll be learning it. Likewise, in this particular tool, right? So we'll be learning everything like end to end, how to use this particular tool, each and every options we will be learning. So I'll be teaching end to end in Power BI so that even if you get a job, like with 3 years or 4 years or how much ever the experience you are keeping, you'll be able to comfortably work on it because complete knowledge you will be having it with this particular training. See any company, right? So if you're working properly, that is what they wanted. It doesn't matter, right? So if you learn completely this tool, right? Power BI tool, and also let's say this is there, this chart, whether this number is correct or wrong, in order to identify or do it. So that's where SQL also is required. In order to work on the data modeling side and structuring side, you should have awareness about the data warehousing concepts, right? So everything I'll be going to cover in this particular training. So if you look at the first slide, so I'm going to cover the data warehouse side where we will understand the data and Power BI report when we develop something in order to verify whether the numbers are correct or wrong. So we'll be doing with SQL writing queries. So that also we'll learn in this training. So everything we will learn it, then it is easy that we can work on this particular tool. Okay. And you have seen it just now, right? So with very, very simple steps, so we were able to create the report on this particular one. Then, so if you want to analyze if end users, right, how they access the reports. So when you publish into the service, like right now I'm just publishing into server, right? So when I publish into server, so any of the workspace, so when we publish it like this, where we give the access in the server to the end users, business users mainly, right? They will access the reports through online. See, now it is a web. Web means through link. So we are able to access the reports, right? So if you could see, I can make it full screen and we can see the data. So when I, it is interactive also, when I click on something, it will interactive also, it will be interactive also. Yeah. So this is how we can create the reports using this Power BI tool. And it is so easy, but we have to learn each and every options available here. So when to use, how to use it, right? So that it is easy when you get a job also. Okay. So this is on Power BI side and Tableau. So Tableau is also there. Like it is also having, as I said, it is easy to work and learn Power BI within less time. So without any coding language, if you want to get a job with decent package, that it is easy in Power BI, and a lot of openings also there in Power BI. Okay, so in the projects, as I said, it is not like right. If you see BI or visualization, the one which we are going to work after getting a job is Power visualization side. It's like we have Power BI, Tableau, lot of BI tools are there, lot of storage tool, lot of ETL tools are there. This is like in a project if you are working on. So we'll have all these, you know, teams will be there, ETL team or database team will be there. So they'll be like, you know, creating packages to pick the data from different sources and loading the data into database. And from here, we connect with the data with Power BI or these kind of tools, right? We have seen it just now, the demo on how to connect with the data and how to create visualizations. So we do it, and so that's at the end, actually. So this is how the standard process looks like, but these are the different tools we have it on to work with. Okay. And always I said, right, like the scope will be always good in to learn Microsoft tools. Any Microsoft tool, if you're learning, which is there in the market, right? Microsoft related things, right? Learning is always will have a stable career, like when you look at like for a long time also. Let's say, for example, Power BI if you're learning. So you can easily work on Power BI for a long time. So because, you know, so people adopt this kind of tools like, and the scope will be very good on learning Microsoft tools. Okay. So we have in Power BI side, SSRS reporting tool is there, but this is like almost outdated now. Like now we have Power BI in the market. So SSRS is also reporting tool only, but people are using this modern BI tool, Power BI. So where within less price and lot of capabilities it has, it is people are using this one. Data modeling tool, SSAS Tableau or MDX Cube, we have it, right? So this is when we have too much data is there. So in order to data model it and work on it, then we'll be using it. Similarly, in Microsoft side, we also have SSIS as a, you know, data ETL tool, or Azure Data Factory in cloud. So these all this Azure is there where we can work on cloud. So even though we have Azure cloud is there, in order to analyze the data or in order to create a reports like this, right? So Power BI is the one where people, everyone use it. Okay. So out of what I want to say is Microsoft tools will always have demand in the market on job opportunities and packages wise. Everything, it is always good. That is the, you know, scope I could say. So as I said, like in this training, so we'll be learning about Power BI desktop. So if you look at here, so whatever this is, the nothing but Power BI desktop. So Power BI desktop is a, you know, developer tool where you we as a developer, Power BI developer, so we will be working on, you know, report development. We will be creating the reports and dashboards, connecting with the data. So we will be learning about this particular, how we can develop it. Right. So we also have we'll be learning service also, where we can publish the reports through online like this, where how we can publish the reports, what and all works we have to do it in the server side. That is also we are going to learn in this training. Also, we also have premium account. So what capabilities premium account is having, what capabilities pro account is having, we're going to learn it. So this is the different types of licenses available in Power BI side. So Power BI desktop is a free. If you want to learn Power BI desktop, we can easily download it and we can learn it free of cost. You know, we can use it without having any license. right? In order to explore the server side, we should have, we have two kind of servers are there, licenses, Power BI Pro and Premium. It is like Premium will have some more benefits extra than the Pro account. In the companies, right, in projects, it depends on the usage and benefits, what they require. They can choose to go with Pro account or Premium license for their, you know, project, right? So that is how the, you know, differences it will be for Premium and Pro account. For learning also, we can easily do it. Even for, if you want to learn about Pro or Premium also, so we can create a license free of cost in Power BI. I will guide you that how to create a license and how we can explore the server also, so that we can be, you know, having knowledge on both the end, different side. Like this is the, you know, to give brief about, you know, Power BI products and also the types of licenses we have it, which we can learn it in upcoming lessons. Okay. So as I told, this is also interface where we have connected with this particular tool and created the some of the visualization, that is we have already done it. So this is the interface of Power BI tool. Okay. And every month we'll have new updates and new features also, which is coming. So everything I will guide you, like, you know, so from, you know, when I started working on Power BI, what options was there and currently what options latest we get it, which latest futures. So those and all, I'll guide everything in my training, which will give you complete picture about, you know, Power BI and also different features, which we have it in this one. Okay. So basically I'll be covering end to end, like in this tool, like where I have already given the demo, right? Each and every option, I'll go to this one. When I click on this one, we'll get one more hidden tabs, like you could see here, this one. Even when you click on data side, so we get other hidden tabs. So when you click on columns and these things, we also get other hidden tabs. Everything will go through each and every option so that we'll have complete idea about this tool, so that it is easy and comfort for us to work on this particular one. Okay, so that is on this particular tool side where we will be going to learn about. So I just want to tell you, like, how we start our training and how I will end our training. So what and all I'm going to cover in this training. So I'm just telling you, this is the roadmap of our training. So today I just covered the overview about the training, right? Overview session, I just covered about the training today, right? From tomorrow onwards, we will have classes on data warehousing mainly. When I say data warehousing, so we'll be talking about different data models, how is the data is there. It's all about, we will be learning about data. What is data? What are the basic elements? And these things are there to learn within data side. So we'll be going to learn about in data warehousing. After that, how to create a database, how to create a tables, how to load the data into the DB, and how we can connect with the same tables into the Power BI desktop, which we have connected already, right? So how we can connect, what are the different connections which is supporting in Power BI. So everything will be, you know, learning in this one. Also visualization side, right? So we should not blindly use whatever the visual, right? We should know when to use which visual, right? And as I said, it is not always drag and drop like this to create a report, right? So we have to create required measures and columns as per the business requirement, right? That is one of the main thing in Power BI to learn with. So that I'm going to cover 230 DAX functions with examples in my training, so that using this particular knowledge, it is easy that you can use that functions and create required measures as per the business requirement, and you can drag and drop and create the reports. Okay, so desktop end to end I'll cover it, then use visuals, how to use it, then Power BI service I will start with. Power BI server means, like, in the server, how, what and all is there in interview questions, and also in server, what is the works we will be doing in our regular job. Those things I'll cover it. Then, as I said, so some of the projects, right, if they have huge data, they will be depending on data modeling tool, SSAS, SQL Server Analysis Services, right? So that tool also I'm going to cover it in this training. So where you will be learning about how we can create a data model using SSIS Tabular, how we can deploy it, so that you can keep that as a, that also as additional skill you have it in your resume, so that more demand will be there for your profile. Okay, so we'll cover that also end to end, so that if you get a chance to work on this one also, you can do it. Right, some projects they would need SSIS Tabular model developer, where to create, connect with the data and create a data model and deploy it, and so that we can connect with this particular model with Power BI Desktop to create the reports. Right, as we start, like initially, like we will be studying with SQL basics, right? So we will study basics right here in the initially. After that, I will also cover the advanced concepts, advanced SQL concepts, so that, you know, if you want to try for SQL jobs also, you can try it. The knowledge which I'm going to give, if you want to try as a database engineer, you can try for opportunities. If you want to try for SSIS Tabular model, you can try it. If you want to try for Power BI developer, you can try it. Okay, so all this, this is how the roadmap will be. I will also cover, take, you know, real-time project explanation class. So where you will feel very, you know, comfortable how the projects will come and what exactly how our work will be started. What is the daily work we will be doing it? How exactly the projects will start? Everything I'll cover it so that it will be easy and comfortable for you. Okay. So that is also I'm going to cover, and I am going to give the resume class to you, where how you can create a resume and how you can create how you can upload your resume in job portals to get calls and attend the interviews also, right? So while I take the daily sessions, right, like daily classes, so after 2-3 classes I'll start taking the mock interviews also. Mock interviews means I'll be asking you the questions on the classes which we go with, so that you can, you know, learn it same time while attending the classes. It will be easy while attending the interviews also, as you are already prepared and attending the interviews. So which I ask interview questions, which is regularly asked in the interviews, that also I'll cover it, so that you will have idea on there. Also, I'll be sharing the reports, around 40 to 50 reports. I'll share it for hands-on practice purpose. So that the more practice you do it, the more easy it becomes, the BI tool, the Power BI tool becomes to you. So that if you get a job also, you can comfortably, you can work on it, as you have already worked on 40 reports, which I have already shared, right? So also the class recordings daily, I will be providing you, right? So on daily basis, I'll be providing the class recordings. So once I complete the training, from that date, I'll be giving 5 months of access, right? Let's say, so from today, I'll start the training, like 2 months I'll take it to complete it. After the 2 months, I'll give 5 months. Usually I was giving only 5 months previously, but now I'm extended to give 2 more months extra, so that, you know, it will benefit you to learn and revise and go through, right? Even though if somebody is new to this particular domain, don't think about I'm a BCom or mechanical or civil engineering, I have done it. Any degree is fine for to get this job. Only that you should have complete knowledge, then it is easy that you can work on it. So if you're from different background, if you're not able to understand it properly, I would suggest go through these recordings daily basis multiple times. Today class happened. After that, you can go again in the afternoon or evening whenever you are free. Multiple times go through this recordings and understand it, so that it helps you to have complete knowledge there. Also, I will provide end-to-end materials, you know, for you to learn with. So that is, that will help you through to learn and practice, and even interview purpose also, you can prepare it using the same notes. You can answer in interview, that will help you also. Okay. All the materials I'll provide you, like on this particular area, like data warehousing, SQL, Power BI, desktop and DAX functions, everything I'll be going to provide that. Also, placements also I'll be giving for sure, 100% I'll provide the placement support, but that cost will be extra. For training, I'll be charged, right? I think most of you are aware, the training cost will be 10,000 for 2 months of training. daily the classes will be 7:30 to 9 a.m. Right, 1.5 hour the training will be. Right, so placements, anybody wants, I can help you on the placements also. But I would suggest lot of people, right, like lot of my students, they got a job on their own with the knowledge which I have shared end to end. If you completely focus on this training and learn it effectively, you can get your job on your own. Okay, so that is on this particular one. So if you want like other videos, like which I have given training, like on Tableau and MSBI SSIS ETL tool. So if you want to go through, you can go through this, subscribe this channel in YouTube, Corporate Trainer Naveen, so that, you know, so you can, you know, go through this recordings also. Okay, so that's it, like on this particular training and roadmap, how we are going to give it. As I told, so we'll have regular classes from tomorrow, from 7:30 a.m. to 9 a.m. There will be only one batch I take it because of my, you know, work and schedules. I will be taking only one batch always. Until I complete this batch, I will not be able to take another batch also, right? So maybe I will take the planned batch will be, next will be, I will be taking on March actually. Now I'm starting, right? I'll take 2 months to complete this training. Then we'll start another batch on March only. Okay. So always I'll take in the morning only. There is no other alternative batch. Only on online only I'll take. There is no offline classes also. Okay. So this is all about the training and the, you know, roadmap. If you have any open questions, you can feel free to ask me. For placements, you can also, as I said, so we can talk about the placements. You can connect with me, okay? For placements, you can reach out to me directly. For other things, any questions are there? Any doubts is there? Please feel free to ask me. Any questions? Yes. Yes, sir, tell me. Unmute yourself and ask your questions. Any questions you have, it you can ask.
Hello, Naveen.
Yes, yes.
Yeah, Srinivas here. So we need to practice. You can send that links, right? To download the Power BI.
Yes, yes. Which one download?
Okay. You see, to practice Power BI.
Yeah, yeah, I'll be sharing, you know, 40 reports where you can, you know, practice using them and go through these recordings multiple times regularly, and you can learn it. Okay. And the one thing I would like to tell you is placement charges will be different for my students and, you know, other students, right? So placements will be, you know, charges is different for my students and other students. So my students, it will be less, and other students will be more. For placements, that is also I want to convey one thing. Placements, I will always give priority to my students. Others, if I have time, I will give it for other people who is coming from outside. Yeah, so any other questions anyone has? Anyone of you?
Naveen, Harish, yeah.
Yeah, please go through your questions. Ask me your questions. Any questions anyone has, please ask me.
Hi, Naveen. This is Dodaya.
No need to say your name. You can go with your question.
Yeah, okay. I have doubt on, may I know the system performance, I mean features. I have a 2GB RAM system.
It's no, 2GB RAM, it will be difficult to work on it. So I see the basic system which you can comfortably learn and you know, work on it is like at least if you have i5 processor, Intel i5 processor, it works very good. Okay. Even I'm using i5. Okay. So i5 processor laptop is there, it is well and good. i3 is there also. If you have already purchased i3, you can manage it actually, but it will be very slow only. So if you go with other processors, laptops also, AMD, all these things, it will be very slow. Okay. Some of the, you know, softwares also, it will not support to install it also. So i5 with 8 GB RAM is very good. Any laptop, Intel i5 processor and 8 GB RAM is sufficient.
So okay, now.
Any other questions?
Naveen, from where we can upload our resumes to start interviews after,
I'll guide them. Right? In upcoming classes, I'll be guiding them. Okay, I have this one, right? I will guide that.
Okay.
Yeah, any other questions?
Sir, Chromebook supports.
Yeah, tell me.
HP Chromebook supports this app, sir.
HP Chromebook, what is the processor it is? i5 or i3 or what is the processor it is? Intel i3 or any other processor?
i3
it is manageable. Okay, see, laptop HP or Acer or anything, any laptop is fine, but i5 processor is recommended. It is good actually, but i3 manageable. You can manage it. Again, no need to purchase it. Maybe you can increase the RAM size and do it. Yeah, so I think that's it from my end. If no questions, we'll close this session now.
The fees amount, we have to pay lump sum or we can pay in
installments? You can pay initially 5,000. Total is 10,000, right? So 5,000 initially you can pay. Okay. And another 5,000 after 20 days you can pay. After 20 days from now.
Okay. Thank you.
Sir, how much salary is provided for professors?
One by one. Yeah, Pavan. So how much salary is like based on the experience and your current salary, right? There are people who is having 5 years experience with 9 lakhs current salary, they can get 20 lakhs package also, right? So if you want to try, like if you're having very less, right? Usually in software industry, 1 year, 2 to 3 lakhs, they'll pay. Based on the knowledge and demand, 2 to 3 lakhs, they'll pay. So for existing, like for example, I have a 6 lakhs package. So I can try to get, 10 lakhs package. From 6 lakhs to 10 lakhs, I can easily try it. Okay. So it is like that, we can get it. So to calls and all, like nowadays I'm seeing 2.5 or 2 years minimum, it should be there to get calls. If you want to get more calls, 3+ should be there. 3+ experience. Freshers also there, but very less calls are there.
Sir, is there any major openings for jobs, sir?
Yeah, there
major
are
or minor.
There are like major openings as it is a new tool and people are, a lot of companies are choosing Power BI as a reporting tool, right? So they are in that companies, there will be bulk hiring will be there. And the normal companies, it will be like already, they are already having some people are switching. So that time it will be less. So new companies, bulk hiring will be there. If they are switching from Tableau to Power BI, so there are like bulk openings are there. So, and also, as I said, right, there are multi skills which we are learning in this particular training, like data warehousing, SQL, Power BI, MSBI, all these things, advanced SQL, right? If you have multi skills, always more calls will come.
Okay. Yeah. One question. I'm having more than 8 years of experience with Excel and then MSBI. So how the interview calls will be there for the Power BI?
You can get it like if you already have MSBI knowledge, right? It is easy that you can learning also. It is easy for you. And based on your current package, you can get it calls also. You have to keep at least minimum 3 years of experience if you want to work on Power BI, right? So that you get more calls and they'll pick your profile. Okay.
Okay, Naveen. Thank you. And Naveen, one more question regarding like installation. I heard that
I'll guide everything on installation, right?
Okay.
See, software installation, okay. I'll guide in upcoming lessons how to install it, how to do it,
okay.
Everything
okay.
We can connect and I can help you out on that. Okay. Don't worry, okay, on installations and all. Everything I'll guide you. See, you don't know anything means fine. Still, everything end to end, I'll guide you in this particular training, and I'll assist you how to get that, you know, jobs.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, then.
Hello, Naveen. Hello.
Yes.
Last one question. How it will work, placement support? And
I told, right, placement support, you can connect with me separately.
Okay.
It is there, 100% it is there. You can connect with me separately.
Okay, Naveen.
Okay, then.
Sir, can we work in real-time projects?
Yeah, real-time, complete end-to-end tool where real-time scenarios, I'll explain it, and so that it will be easy for you to work on in there. Okay, then I'm closing the session now.
Okay, Naveen. Bye.
Thank you.
Naveen, thank you.
Thank you.
Bye. Thank you, Naveen. Bye.